Hundreds of bald eagles are already gathering at the confluence of the Chehalis and Harrison Rivers. Soon, thousands more will follow from the north to feed on spawning salmon. But where, you might wonder, do they all go when the sun sets?
They come in basically in the late afternoon. They come in from the Chehalis this way, along the edge of the Circular, and others come in through here from the more southern parts of the Fraser Valley.
Just minutes from the river, as the eagle flies, is Echo Lake, a pristine little gem surrounded by some of the oldest trees in southwestern BC.
Almost all the remaining old-growth forests now are on steep slopes at high elevations with much smaller trees. This is extremely rare, lowland, valley-bottom old-growth forest. All of Vancouver and the Lower Mainland used to be like this at one time, and this is one of the last remnants.
The reason? The logging industry loves these forests. They're easy to access, and they have the biggest, most profitable trees.
And in this case, the private lands have obstructed logging for decades. That's why this little enclave of lowland old growth still remains.
Eagles have probably been coming to this, the largest nighttime roosting area in the world, for hundreds of years. They're one reason the Douglas fir and red cedar grow so strong and so tall.
They spend the night doing their droppings there, and that's how the nutrition from Canada's greatest salmon river, the Chehalis Harrison, gets that nutrition spread across this mountainside.
Recently, the province, which owns the majority of this land, proposed turning half of the forest into a protected area. Good news for the 45 hectares on the south side of the lake, not so good for the other half.
Most of what you see in front of you on the west and the north side is not proposed for protection, and we need to get all of the old growth forests and the mature forests around the lake protected. That's almost common sense.
The Ancient Forest Alliance hopes the government will protect all 100 hectares around Echo Lake. It may not sound like a lot of land, but it makes up a significant part of the 1% of Douglas fir old growth that remains in this part of the province.
Very few people know that this is still here, that we still have something as special as this. We've checked all over the valleys in this region, and they're gone, except for this area.